All right, Shalawan brothers, coming back again to prophesy the downfall of America out on the highways and the byways as it is commanded in the scriptures to do. All right, and to let the Negro, Latinos, and Native American Indians know that you are the true Hebrew Israelites of the Bible. All right, you're not known as these bywords, a Negro, Mexican, Hispanic, Chicano, none of those, you know, a Negro from Africa. You're not known by none of those names, man. You're a Hebrew Israelite, okay? Despise of what contemporary America deems you as, okay? Because we were a people before a place. We're Hebrew Israelites from the land of from Yasha'ala, which means he is a prince of power. That's what Israel means, Yasha'ala. All right. So that's what our job is to do, is to draw you back to your nationality, to your true heritage, man. All right, and to let you know that everything that's going on in the earth right now is prophesied in the scriptures. All right. Now I'll bring out a scripture in Romans 13 and 11. And that, knowing the time, that now it is high time to awake out of sleep. Right. So it's time to wake out of sleep, man. It's high time, man. All right. Everything that's going on, man, is like I said, it's prophesied that was going to happen. Okay. There's going to be rumors of wars. There's going to be, mass killings on the earth. But we haven't even seen it at a great scale that we're about to come into, man. All right, when the Third World War actually comes to play, there's gonna be mass killings in the earth, man. Here in America too, they're gonna declare martial law. All right, they got their concentration camps ready, FEMA. All right, now it's time to wake out of sleep, man, and take heed to these warnings, man. But only the elect are going to be the ones that are going to take heed to these warnings. Everybody else is going to remain asleep, man. All right. And that's who we're sounding the trumpet to. Sounding the alarm is to the elect, the ones that are still out there, that are waiting to be woken up. That's who this message, the gospel, is supposed to be preached to. All right. Everybody else is going to just ignore it. All right. And walk into their death, man. Okay. It says, and that knowing the time, that now it is high time to awake out of sleep. For now is our salvation nearer than we believed. It's more closer than you ever thought, man. You know, but you still got a lot of people that are just playing around, laughing and giggling, you know, not taking nothing serious, you know. But that's when the scriptures say, when they shall say peace and safety, sudden destruction shall fall upon them, man. All right, and that's what's going on all across the world right now. Everybody's saying peace and safety, primarily here in America, because everybody thinks they're in a comfortable state, man. They think that they're going to get away with the judgment that has been prepared for them from the beginning, man. From breaking the law, statutes, and commandments of the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. Not that so-called white Jesus, man. Jesus Cristo. That's not his name. Okay? That's what's prophesied in the Bible to come, man. It's death. The Lord ain't coming back to hand out roses and gifts and Easter eggs. He's coming back as a man of war, man. And you're never going to listen if somebody comes and talks to you softly. You're never going to listen. You know, to you guys and people out there that have a problem with when a man comes out here with the austerity, all right, with the hard look. The scriptures say, sound the trumpet, man. You got to lift up thy voice and sound the trumpet and show my people their transgressions, man. You know? Everybody likes to think that they got the Bible and the Lord is in their heart and all this, that, and the third. But really, the Bible's not even, the Lord's not with you, man. You're fooling yourself, man. But like the scriptures say, your salvation is nearer than you believe, man. Nope, and that's only pertaining to you Negro Latinos and Native American Indians, man. All right? That's who the Lord is coming back for. All right? And that's who we're harping the sound of the trumpet to. Okay? To the ones that are destined, the elect, man. All right? Not all you so-called Negro Latinos and Native American Indians are going to be delivered, man. This is Isaiah 45 and 17. But Israel, right, Yasha'Allah, he is a prince of power, shall be saved in the Lord with an everlasting salvation. Ye shall not be ashamed nor confounded, world without end. So, going back to John 3:16, that's who that world pertains to, is the world of Israel, Yasha'Allah, the Negro, Latino, and Native American Indians, man. Okay? Now it's time to wake out of sleep. Now I'm going to bring out that word, I'm going to look up that word in Hebrews 13 and 11. All right? Let's go right here, Hebrews 13 and 11. Romans 13 and 11. All right, let's see what that word, that word sleep is, because it says, it gives us a commandment to wake out of sleep, right? All right, let's see what it is. It's in the Strong's Concordance, the Blue Letter Bible. It says hypnos, all right, subsilence, sleep, spiritual torpor. I don't know what that really, that word means. All right, let me look over here at the Thayer's Greek Lexicon. All right, basically it's a metaphor, you know what I'm saying, to be I guess subsilence. Let me look up that word torpor. All right, because that's a commandment to the elect, that we have to wake out of sleep, man. All right, because when everything starts popping off, man, a lot of you people are gonna be, that's when y'all gonna, a lot of y'all gonna start drawing back to the Lord. All right, this is that word torpor. Let me see how to pronounce that word. It's T-O-P-O-R. When you go into the Blue Letter Bible,
Toper.
You go into the Blue Letter Bible, you look up that word sleep. It goes back to hypnos, and it has a word Toper, and it means a state of mental and physical inactivity or insensibility. So that's what it means when you have to wake out of sleep, man. You got to wake up from that deep slumber, your spirituality, man. But only Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai can activate that, man. All right, that's it. It says lethargy, apathy. It says the dormant, inactive state or of an hibernating. That's what it is. It's like you're in hibernation. You have your spirit closed up, but really it's the Lord who closed you up, man. The Spirit of the Lord has closed you up, all right, from receiving this truth. It says God. So that's what the word sleep means, is to be under hypnosis, man. And we all know how that occurred, is by you breaking the law, statutes, and commandments, man. You discontinued from your heritage and took on the hedonistic customs and traditions. So that, in return, has blinded you from receiving the true wisdom of knowledge, the knowledge, wisdom, and understanding of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. So you're not going to wake out of sleep, you two-thirds. But the elect are going to wake up out of that sleep. And they're going to know who they are. All right? Khan, let me go over here into the book of Ecclesiasticus, the book of Sirach. All right, it says Sirach chapter 13 verse 13. It says, observe and take good heed, for thou walkest in peril of thy overthrowing. And that's a warning to you Negro, Latino, the Native American Indians. The scriptures say, he that had ears, let him hear. All right? So if you can hear this, you walk in peril, man. Right now as you speak and walk, right now as you drive and you walk, you're walking in peril, man. At any time, the Most High can require your soul, man, right then and there. All right? So it says, observe and take good heed, for thou walkest in peril of thy overthrowing. When thou hearest these things, awaken that in thy sleep. So the Lord is commanding you Negro, Latinos, and Native American Indians to wake out of sleep, man. Get out of that state of hypnosis, because that's what America has done to you Negro, Latinos, and Native American Indians. All right? Through the media, through the music, through the food. It's all lowered our frequency, man, that we have a connection with our power, which is Yahweh Shai, who y'all ignorantly call Jesus Christ, man. So it's time to wake out of that hypnosis, man. Cast off that spell, man, because there's a witch. Esau, the so-called white man, cast that on you, man. You know? You got to put on that hope, that the spirit of Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. Okay? But like it says, awake in thy sleep, man. You need to wake up from that spiritual slumber. Okay? You need to wake up. All right? And get this truth, man. You know? It's just like when the 10 virgins, 5 of them were wise and 5 were unwise, and 5 of them took oil with them and the other 5 didn't. But the scriptures say they all slumbered, right? Talking about the captivity, that slavery. But now we're coming back to that true nationality, all right? Now you got some demons out here, man. You got these demons out here, man. You know what I'm saying? Because he knows that he has but a short time, Esau, man. All right, these devils, man. They think this is a light thing, but when they catch that fire on them, they're gonna be yelling the same way, but 10 times more than that, man. When them ICBM missiles catch you on fire, man. You think that this is hell that you're living in right now? Just wait until what the Most High God's prepared. All right. Matter of fact, like I was gonna get into, man. Y'all don't discern the times, man. Y'all don't discern the times. Y'all are worried about what Kim Kardashian, Kanye West is doing. You know, all these little other shitty ass rappers, you know, that they're coming out with. Can't even understand what they're talking about. You know? This is Psalms chapter 7, verse 11. Yahweh judgeth the righteous, and Yahweh is angry with the wicked every day. So the Most High is wicked with the is angry with the wicked every day, man. That's why he said that in thy walking, thy walkest in peril of thy overthrowing, man. Okay? Because it's Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai who kills and makes alive, man. Y'all don't control nothing. Okay? Psalm 6 or 7 and 12. If he turn not, he will wet his sword. Right, so that word wet means to sharpen. So Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai is sharpening up his judgment to put upon you 2/3, you heathens. All right, this land called America. All right, to take out the enemy, man. Okay? It says, if he turn not, he will wet his sword. He hath bent his bow and made it ready. He hath also prepared for him the instruments of death. He ordaineth his arrows against the persecutors. You see? So those that have persecuted us are going to be in great torments, man. Those that have lived deliciously on this side and received their consolation on this side, you're going to be thrown in that overthrowing, man. You're going to be caught in that overthrowing, that thresh, all right? You're going to be thrust through, man, all right, with that instrument of death. Jacob is likened unto a threshing instrument, man. You're not going to escape the sword, man. It's like whenever you're asleep and somebody comes and wakes you up real quick and hard. What happens, man? You wake up all like you don't know where you're at. You got some people wake up with a fear on their face. Some people wake up pissed off, you know? Because you don't want to be woken up in that manner whenever the Lord decides to come back, man. It's time to wake up now and to receive it, man. Because discerning the times is very important, man. You have to discern the times that you're living in. And that's why the Most High set up certain men to come out here and to teach you that. To let you know that the times we're living in, man. That these times are evil. These days are evil, man. There's nothing good about this place, man. You have to realize that. That's part of accepting wisdom, man, is that this place is evil. It says, that's it on Psalm 7. All right, let me come over here. Right, you know, because when you least expect it, you're going to be caught out there, man, you know, Let me go ahead and go over here to Matthew chapter 24. All right. Matthew chapter 24, verse 42. It says, "Watch therefore, for you know not what hour the Lord doth come." So that's another commandment, that we have to wake out of sleep. And when you wake out of sleep, what do you do next? You have to watch. All right? Be circumspect. All right? It says, "Watch therefore, for you know not what hour your Lord doth come. But know this, that if the good man of the house had known in what watch the thief would come, he would have watched and would not have suffered his house to be broken up." Right? You know? So if you were wise, you would know that you would have to, if you were wise, you would know you had to watch. You'd have to discern the times. You know? Get another scripture. I quoted it earlier, but I'm going to just go ahead and just bring it out. But yeah, man, you know, that's the state that we're in, man. The spirit right now is the spirit of slumbers, right? Is around, man. The spirit of slumbers here, man. All right. This is 1 Thessalonians 5 and 2. "For yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night. For when they shall say peace and safety, then sudden destruction cometh upon them, as travail upon a woman with child, and they shall not escape." Why? Because you weren't watching. You weren't paying attention. You weren't being preoccupied in prophecy. All right? You weren't studying. Okay? Another scripture is in the book of Romans 11, and I start at verse 7. "What then? Yet Israel had not obtained that which he seeketh for, but the election had obtained it, and the rest were blinded." So there's a mass multitude that is blinded from receiving this truth, the gospel, man, the true doctrine, the true teachings of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. All right? And there's nothing that I can do or any man on this earth could do for you to receive this truth, man. It's going to be done by Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. And it's going to be through thermonuclear destruction, man, that fire. Okay? Everything else, man, is out of our control. All I can do is preach the word, man. Relay the message and move, man. Get it moving. You know what I'm saying? Romans 11 and 8. "According as it is written, Yahweh hath given them the spirit of slumber, eyes that they should not see, and ears that they should not hear unto this day." Right? So you're not going to hear the sound of the trumpet. Right? You're not going to hear when a man is telling you, "Walk this way, come this way. Salvation is right here. Take this bread of life. Take this water of life." All right? You're going to reject it. You're going to remain in that state of hypnosis, in that state of sleepiness. All right? But it says that y'all in the spirit of slumber has been poured out upon you by, and it's by Yahweh Shai, man. All right? Next scripture I want to get. It's in 2 Corinthians. All right? This is 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 3. "But if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost." Right? And the word gospel means good news. Right? Or good tidings. All right? And the good news is that Israel, you Negro Latinos and Native American Indians, are about to be delivered, man. The elect. All right? And ultimately, the rest of you, the rest of Yasha'Allah is going to be brought back in the kingdom, man. All right? "But if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost." Lost in what? You're lost in this world. You're lost in money. You're lost in the flesh. You're lost in the money, women, the material, the pride of life. All right? You're more concerned about here right now instead of what's going to come in the future. "In whom the god of this world hath blinded the minds of them which believe not." Right? And the god of this world is who? Esau, man. A so-called white man. The prince of the power of the air, man. And he blinds y'all's minds through, like I said earlier, through the media, all right? Through giving you the so-called liberty to do whatever you want, live however you want, all right? You can indulge in all types of wickedness, fulfill your lust, and without being judged between life and death, all right? It says, in whom the God of this world hath blinded the minds of them which believe not. So that's good in the sight of the eyes of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shah, because he never wanted you in the first place, man. Alright? Lest the light of the glorious gospel of Yahweh Shah Mashiach, who is the image of Yahweh, should shine unto them. So it takes a higher power for you to receive this truth. That's why, man, we're blessed, Akim. We're blessed that we have this knowledge, man. We're blessed that we're able to put on this garment. First and foremost, a spiritual garment, and to come out here and to preach, man. To stand in great boldness, to stand in our lot, man. To come out to the highways and the hedges and to preach, to prophesy, exhort, and admonish, rebuke, all of it, man. Not just one thing. To know that we ain't nothing. To know that we base everything off faith and hope, man. And Lord will, we're going to be delivered for having that attitude. You know? Because these people ain't doing it, man. You know? All these people are, all they're doing is just one big act, man. It's just one big act. And we're the only ones that are living the honest, true life. We know what's really going on, man. We see everything for what is really going on. We're living in, we're as filthy rags in the eyes of the world, man. It's like in the movie Matrix. They're the ones that were taken out of the Matrix, they were the ones that were the same. You see what I'm saying? They weren't vessels. Like here in America, the two-thirds, the Negro Latinos, the Native American Indians, y'all are used by Esau, man. All right? He put spirits on you, you know, through the media. Women put spirits on you, you know? It says, what was that? Come on, but there's a scripture. Let's see here. Bring out another script before I go back to Matthew 24. This is Matthew 13 and 16. It says, but blessed are your eyes, for they hear, for they see, and your ears, for they hear. Right? So we're blessed that we've been woken up to the truth, man. We're blessed that we've been woken up to the truth. It's an honor to come out here and to present your body a living sacrifice for your king, man, for Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shah. Okay? Because the Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, he's coming back to deliver you Negro Latinos and Native American Indians, man. To take you out of this land of oppression. The Valley of the Shadow of Death, which is America, man, which is known as Babylon, Sodom and Egypt, you know? But to us, the Akim that are in the know, we're blessed, man. It says, for verily I say unto you that many prophets and righteous men have desired to see those things which you see and have not seen them, and to hear those things which you hear and have not heard of them. You know? So it's a blessing, man. Not even the angels in heaven desire to look into the things that we've been ordained to have, man. The mysteries. You know, because we've been partakers with Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, man. Okay? I'm gonna bring out that script. I'm gonna bring out that script. Khan right here. It says 1 Peter's chapter 1. Right? 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 10. Of which salvation the prophets have inquired and searched diligently, who prophesied of the grace that should come unto you. So that's what we're preaching, man. We're preaching the salvation unto the Negro Latinos and Native American Indians. All right? Which the prophets of old, they did the same thing. Because we all come back in our same lot. Searching what? Of what manner of time the spirit of Yahweh HaMashiach, which was in them, did signify, when it testified beforehand the sufferings of Yahweh Shai Mashiach and the glory that should follow. Because they were always looking
for the Messiah, man. They wanted the Messiah to come. Just like us right now, we know he came. Now we're waiting for him to come back. All right, but the prophets of old are back in their same lot to this very day. Verse 12, 1 Peter 1 and 12. Unto whom it was revealed, and not unto themselves, but unto us, they did minister the things which are now reported unto you by them that have preached the gospel unto you with the Holy Spirit sent down from heaven. Right, and that's, we come to the word, man. The word of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. All right, that's how we push and preach the word, man. All right, and that's how we know that this is the truth, man. All right, it says 1 Peter 1, and I'm going to start where I left off, which things the angels desire to look into, you see? So we're blessed, man, because not even the angels know certain things that we know. You know, the angels in heaven. But us as men on the earth that the Lord loves, Yasha'Allah, his elect, his precious, he has given us this wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, man, to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, man. All right. I'm going to go ahead and just bring out Titus 1 and 1. It says, Paul, the servant of Yahweh and an apostle of Yahweh Shai Mashiach, according to the faith of Yahweh's elect. So Paul, he was sent. Paul was sent to the elect of Israel. All right? Because Israel, Yasha'Allah, the Negro Latinos and Native American Indians, they are the elect, but there's an elect within the elect. And the elect that he's coming back for is that small remnant, the 144,000 and that multitude that followed behind them. So that's who he went to go preach to. It says, Paul, a servant of Yahweh and an apostle of Yahweh Shai Mashiach, according to the faith of God's elect and the acknowledging of the truth, which is after godliness, right? Which is after God. Because in order for you to acknowledge this is the truth, it has to be done through godliness, man. It has to be a spiritual, an awakening, spiritual awakening from up on high, man. All right? For a higher power to wake you out of that state of hypnosis, man, the spirit to make you into a spiritual man, and to take off the carnality, man, to tear away the flesh. It says in hope, Titus 1 and 2, in hope of eternal life, which Yahweh, that cannot lie, promised before the world began, but hath in due times manifested his word through preaching. Right, so that's how we put the word, man. It's through sounding the trumpet. That's how we manifest the hidden mysteries of the gospel. It's coming out to the highways and the byways, man. You know, making things plain upon the table for people to see. But only the elect are gonna be able to see and know that this is real food. Everybody else is gonna look at it like, oh, that's something I don't want to eat. They just like with kids today; they don't like to eat vegetables. That's how you people are. Y'all don't want to come and get these greens, man. All right? To be chlorophyte, which means chlorophyte, which comes from certain greens. All right? Like wheatgrass, spirulina. It has chlorophyll, which basically means life, man. Makes green. All right? That's what we need in our body, man, to give us a beautiful glow, you know? It says, but hath in due times manifested his word through preaching, which is committed unto me according to the commandment of Yahweh, our Savior, all right? Which is through his son, Yahweh Shai. So that's how one is going to be woken up, is through preaching, man, all right? And we are blessed, Akim, you know? Everybody else is bullshitting, basically, man. They're casting it away. They're pulling away their shoulder. They're stopping up their own ears, you know? But it's all right, you know, because we're only concerned about the elect. It's like Paul said, you know. This is Romans 10 and 13. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved, right? And people could use that scripture to try to justify that everybody can be saved, all right? That whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. But the scriptures say you got to do precept upon precept, line upon line, here a little, there a little. But when you go into the book of Joel, it tells you who can be saved. And it's talking about the nation of Israel, the Negro Latinos and Native American Indians, man. It's not talking about everybody on the planet Earth. All right, it says, Romans 10 and 14, how then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in him of whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher? So you're never gonna hear. You're never gonna be woken up out of that state of hypnosis, that state of sleepiness, unless a preacher is sent. Unless Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai puts a spirit on an individual to come out here and push this word, man. To break down the parables, to give you the proper breakdown of the scriptures. All right? That's the only way that you're gonna wake up out of sleep, man. Lord will, if the Lord allows that to happen, though, you know. It says, going back to Romans 10 and 15, and how are they preach? And how shall they preach except they be sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of them that preach the gospel of peace and bring glad tidings of good things. But they have not all obeyed the gospel. For Isaiah saith, Lord, who hath believed our report? So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of Yahweh. See? So it's going into how one is going to hear, how one is going to be woken up from that state of sleepiness, man. All right? Being under that state of hypnosis, it takes spiritual power to wake one up, man. You know? It takes spiritual power to wake one up, and that's through the preaching, man. Through prophesying, coming out of the words of the Heavenly Father's book, man. You know, that's the only way. Everything, no other way can take you and deliver you, man. All right. It says Isaiah 10 and 18. But I say, had they not heard? Yes, verily, their sound went out into all the earth, and their words unto the ends of the world. Right, so there's no excuse for any of you people, man. Because y'all all at one time seen it, glanced at it, heard it. Alright? Because you can hear, but you're not hearing. Alright? Like, you can hear the word being told to you. You can hear that America's going to be destroyed, that you're a Hebrew Israelite. But you weren't eating it, man. You know what I'm saying? You weren't digesting it. You weren't letting it be part of you. You were rejecting it, you know? But all that's going to come back to remembrance, man. You're going to remember, oh, I remember him talking about that. I remember him saying that this was going to come to pass, man. But by that time, when that time happens, too late. You're going to be destroyed, man. You know? You're going to be caught out. You're going to be caught out, out here, man, being killed, man. All because you despise the Heavenly Father's word, man. All right? Bring out another scripture. In the book of Proverbs. All right, Proverbs. Come on. This is Proverbs chapter 13, verse 13.